Rob, what's the difference between a Carlisle surprise, a reverse Canterbury pleasure, and a sheep tied to a lamppost in Cardiff?
Now, this is another example of the institutionalised racism which is accepted when it's directed towards the Welsh. Yeah. As it has been done. Is this a reference to the joke about the about what is a sheep tied to a lamppost in Cardiff? It's a leisure centre.
It's also
no,
a good
no, 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 no. And you know.
No.
You
no,
know.
No.
And you know. No. What is the difference? Well, the only thing I have knowledge of is the sheep type. No, I mean, I have knowledge of Cardiff. I don't. Well, I'm not really aware what a Carlisle surprise is, other than the shock of finding yourself at Carlisle. Which would be surely more of a delight than anything
yes,
else.
Yes, a total delight.
A reverse Canterbury.
The full name is a reverse Canterbury pleasure, place double. It's an ancient English pastime.
Was it Morris dance? Is it, not, is it a type of Morris dance?
Not Morris dancing, no. It has musical
breakdance
nature. It's not a dance. It's really big. It's as big a musical instrument as you could ever find.
A whale. Instead of the whale, you just put your hand over the blowhole. The whale joins in.
He's making jokes about whales. No. The name for this pastime comes from originally from the Latin for countryside, but a particular part of the Latin countryside called Campania. And so it's called
bells,
Campanology.
Bells.
Absolutely yes, right. It's bell ringing.
Yes.
Bell ringing.
Bell ringing. It's bells are. Well, and they're tunes, or rather methods, as bell ringers call them. They're uniquely English. And if you have six bells, there are how many different permutations of six bells? Well, six times five times four times three times two.
Lots and lots.
720.
And lots. Oh.
And if you play through each one of those permutations, that's called a peal of bells. And it's also called an English phrase we use quite a lot, ringing the changes, because those sequences are called changes. That's where the phrase to ring the changes comes from.
Quite interesting.
Because if you have 12 bells, there are 479,1,600 variations. So that would take 38 years to ring a peal of 12 bells.
Wow.
Amazing thought, isn't it?
When I was growing up, if my dad hit his thumb with a hammer, which he didn't do often, but occasionally just for a bit of something a bit different, you know, you'd do it, he would say, hell's bells and buckets of blood.
It's a good phrase, hell's bells and buckets of blood. It sounds good, doesn't it? It's a good way of getting out of his system. I'd say f*** him and things like that. Anyway.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.